For the better part of the last week, I've been trying out a whole lot of different jump shots on NBA 2K20 just to see what works. I wanted to find something that was money, and I found a couple, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, if you guys are new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. I try and do this daily. Sometimes I miss a day or two, but you'd like it here. I think you would. Check it out. A lot has changed in terms of shooting. We're gonna get into all that good. Okay, we're gonna get into all that goodness. And I'm gonna share two jump shots with y'all that I swear is money. And Mike Wang, if you patch any of these jump shots, bro, it's gonna be keys. So let's get into it. The last video I made, this is what the tier list looked like. And I told you guys when that video dropped that the game was new. Things were gonna change, sometimes in the form of a patch, or sometimes somebody just found something in one of the badges and it turns out to be OP. This right here is the brand new tier list, ladies and gentlemen. Let's zoom in. I'm not gonna go into all these because there's no need to, but I'm gonna point out the ones that moved up or down. One, Green Machine went up. Used to be tier B, now it's a tier A. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have 20 badges available for shooting and you're not Hall of Faming Green Machine, you're bugging. The name of the game this year is to hit your greens. We don't do whites. Deadeye actually dropped. It's been very controversial. Some people say Deadeye does not work. Some people say Deadeye makes all the difference. Kind of same with difficult shots, to be honest with you. I had Deadeye Hall of Fame for a whole week and I didn't see me hitting more consistent shots. In fact, I found that if I had Hall of Fame Green Machine and Hot Zone Hunter, I felt more confident shooting contested shots than when I had Deadeye. So Green Machine took the A and Deadeye took the B. I've been hearing some good reviews from Steady Shooter, which is weird because if you read the description of the badge, it sounds wildly counterproductive. It's no longer in the worst tier. Doesn't make it usable. I'd still take a lot of other badges over it, but it's a tier C now. Those are kind of like the key points. This is what my badge situation looks like right now. Let me show y'all. All right, let me get a towel. It's just hot, guys. It's because, you know, I live in Atlanta, so it's like, you know, it's mad. All right, so these are the badges I have on my player. Shooting is maxed out. Hall of Fame Catch and Shoot, Hall of Fame Green Machine, Hot Zone Hunter, Range Extender. I actually relegated Quick Draw to gold because that's what I was comfortable with on 2K17, 18, and 19. I don't want those very quick releases. Plus, I'd kind of rather use that upgrade elsewhere, and that silver went to Deadeye. So it is still useful, but I wouldn't remove my Green Machine for a Deadeye. I also said I was gonna try Volume Shooter and I haven't tried it yet. So that's why it's still on no man's land. I still think it has promise. I just haven't gotten a chance to test it. Also, I haven't heard any reviews from Volume Shooter yet. So it still has yet to be placed on the list. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's get into the jump shots. Jump shots are in its essence, very simple. You click square, or is it X on the Xbox? And you let go when it reaches the brim of the shot meter. Don't let anybody complicate it, all right? Because there are a lot of details, but those details shouldn't overwhelm you to the point where you can't even click square no more. It's very, very simple. There are, though, a lot of things that change whether or not a jump shot looks similar for me than it will for you. For example, your player is left-handed or right-handed. What's the wingspan? What's the height on your player? This year, do you have Hall of Fame Quick Draw or no Quick Draw at all? And Quick Draw actually works differently. It does for big man than it does for guard. So it's like, there's a lot of different factors. None of these jump shots I show or anyone shows you will look identical with your player. The goal is though, with any one of these jump shots, is just to have one that's easy enough so that there's an easy cue, you know when to release the square button. It's as simple as that, ladies and gentlemen. Hop into the jump shot creator. And I'll sit here for like 30 minutes to an hour just crafting like 10 or 15 jump shots. And then I spend the next 3 or 4 days just running through those shots over the course of games, just testing them out. One of the jump shots I tested was this one. Now, in previous years, I used to tag Kyrie as my release one and release two, but Kyrie looks totally different this year. And I don't feel comfortable using it. And so I've been looking for substitutes, the two best substitutes I've found so far, which in my opinion even work better than Kyrie did in 18 and 19, is Kyle Korver and Carmelo Anthony. So I've been trying Kyle Korver as a release one and release two on a lot of different bases. This was one of the ones I tested. So I never look at my shot meter when I shoot. You guys know that. If you feel comfortable enough with your jump shot, turn off the shot meter. You get like a 5-6% boost to your shooting this year. So what I'll usually do is I'll just look at the player. When his elbow does that, release the ball. When his feet tap, release the ball. If you can find a cue like that, it's gonna be money for you. Rhythm shooter, easy. But if you're stuck looking at your shot meter, you're never gonna be able to shoot consistently. You shouldn't be looking at your shot meter like that. So if you live near a server or you have fiber internet and you're playing on low latency, congratulations, because you have it the best of all time. You have no idea how good you have it. Because I would die to play in those conditions. In fact, I literally flew to Virginia for a video just to play in those conditions because that's where the NAE server is for NBA 2K. Do you play on a TV instead of a monitor? Probably high latency, right? Do you not have the fastest internet? Probably high latency. Do you play on Wi-Fi instead of wired? Probably high latency. Now, if you're me and you still have all of those things, you still might be playing on high latency. And I live in Atlanta, it's not too far from Virginia. Let's say I release Square here. The extra 50 milliseconds or so of delay is what's gonna carry it to that green window. So you don't want a jump shot the second you release it, it's at the green window. Cause you have to account for the delay, you're playing online. And so the second you can find a jump shot with the easy cue, that has the latency that's gonna hit it in the green, your money, you're never gonna miss. Easy, especially if you have your badges. All right, so let me show you one of the jump shots that I swear to you, is so green, it's scary, it's automatic. It is a Kemba Walker base. I've never done a Kemba Walker base since 2K17, and a Carmelo Anthony as a release one and release two. This is what the jump shot looks like. Remember, I'm using gold quick draw. I do not use Hall of Fame quick draw. And on top of that, I have a 6'6" 3 level scorer, so I have a guard. The jump shot is easy enough. It kind of gives me base 49 Curry vibes from 2K17 and 18. Maybe that's the reason I love it so much. Try the jump shot, and anytime you try a jump shot, look for a cue. Is this when I'm supposed to release it? This jump shot right here, ladies and gentlemen, is my favorite jump shot I've used in years of playing NBA 2K. The base is Jump Shot 98. The release one is Derrick Rose. Release two is Derrick Rose. For those who don't know, NBA 2K Live went out there and did the test. Base 98 has one of the biggest green windows of any base on the game. When I found that information out, I said, well, damn. I'm gonna try and merge it with some releases to see if I can make it work. It's a fairly quick jump shot. It has good limitless range, or now range extender potential, and it's very, very consistent. Look how f***ing beautiful it looks. The second the ball stops moving vertically, that's my cue. I release the square button, the latency carries it to the green window, and it's just cash every single time. And I have a 3-level score. I don't even have a sharp or a stretch. So it's like the fact that I'm shooting that consistently with my build lets me know if I had those 30 shooting badges and a 94 open shot three with boost, it's a wrap, it's over. So if I had to recommend any jump shot, it would be this one right here. Remember, it only works in high latency. If you deal with low latency, you'll end up releasing it too early. You'll get a lot of slightly. But give it like 3 or 4 games and look for that cue I was talking about. So each time I have like a jump shot testing session, this is what it usually looks like. So I'll put all the jump shots that I'm trying to test right here, 98 Rose, 98 Wade, 98 Kemba, 38 Korver, Ben Simmons Korver, and I'll play like 4 or 5 games with them, and I'll try and release it at different points to see if I can find a new, more efficient, or just any kind of cue to know when to release the ball. I'll give it a rating, a 9, a 7, a 2, a 1, a 9, and I'll usually give some sort of feedback as to why I did or didn't like it. I like this jump shot because it works for high latency. 98 Wade and 98 Kemba, I feel like would have worked better on low latency, but unfortunately I don't have that privilege, so I couldn't test it out. But those jump shots looked solid, they just weren't hitting for me, and they were early every single time. Tony Parker Korver, for example, on gold quick draw was just a little too slow. Ben Simmons Korver was basically the same thing, but even slower. And so that's really what I do. I sit there for 30 minutes, craft some jump shots I think will hit, and then I put them on a list, I try them out, test them out, give some feedback, and eventually I run across something as beautiful as 98 Rose. It is a frustrating process because you'll join games and shoot like 1 for 5, and it's like, hi, get me off this horrible jump shot. I've tried, all right? It's been like 4 games. I'm looking like a bucket out here. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's it to the video. Hopefully you guys learned something, enjoyed your time while you were here. But hey, man, look, there's more videos. That's so weird. And look, they're all on the screen floating. I know, it'd be crazy if you clicked one, huh? I'll catch you guys in the next one.